In this episode, I interview Guy Francis. We go to McDonald's in search of his wonderful book, Clark the Shark. And we jury the Bountiful Davis illustration show. Hey guys, this is Will Terry here. Look who I've got in the car with me here.
Guy Francis.
I was just going to hold it on you until you said who you were. Now, we haven't rehearsed anything, right?
No.
So, we're going up to Bountiful, Utah to jury an art show, an illustration show. But I thought, since I have Guy, who is a, or would you say you're a world-famous illustrator?
I would not. I would not say that.
But your Clark the Shark book is now in McDonald's, right?
Yeah.
So
got on the Happy Meal. So it's kind of weird.
So it's the prize in the Happy Meal now?
It was until yesterday.
Oh, yep. Are you serious? Yeah. It's gone now?
Yesterday was the last day.
Ah! That was going to be part of this video, is we were going to stop at McDonald's and get one.
Well, they might still have them.
Well, can we try?
The promotion went from, you know, the 1st of February till Valentine's Day. It's a Valentine's book.
Oh, well, you have one though, right? You went and got one. Yeah. Well, maybe when we go back to your house, I'll have to get one and look at it. Do you actually have the Happy Meal?
I did.
Did you keep the food in it?
Well, you know, they have a shelf life.
Right.
McNuggets. They'll stay for 20 years.
Right.
They're still good.
Okay. All right. I'm going to ask you a few questions, like kind of interview style. Is that all right?
Okay.
As we're driving here. All right, let's start off with an easy one. How much money did you file on your 2015 taxes?
I don't even know. I haven't in the process.
How about an easier one? You can say next question if you don't like. If you don't like the question, just say next question.
All right.
What is your favorite color?
Let's say red.
Okay. How long have you been an illustrator?
Since about 93 or 4.
And
so I don't know how many years that is.
How many horrible jobs have you done? Like the crappy kind.
I can't even count that high. There's been a lot.
So, because a lot of people will tell me how many bad jobs they're getting and how did they get the good ones.
They were bad jobs, though. They were not the jobs that I would have loved to have, but they were jobs that taught me and I got experience from, and it helped my career move forward. So, I mean, they weren't always the funnest jobs, but they were worth doing, even if they were lousy. So,
but you're putting a, like a really bright spin on it. I mean, there were some bad ones, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, I had to. There was the one I'm thinking of right now is I got hired to illustrate in a very realistic style, which I don't do.
Uh-huh.
But it was the cover for the elevator magazine.
What?
Apparently, there's a magazine for elevators. It's very popular among elevator enthusiasts. I don't know. But I had to illustrate this. I had to do a picture of a guy in an elevator, and they wanted it to be realistic, and it was not something that matched my style at all. But at the time, this was right when I was starting out as an illustrator, so you know, I took every job that came to me, even if it wasn't really my thing, because I felt at that time, even if it's a crappy job, I can learn something from it. And so I did, and I worked through it, painted this crappy elevator magazine, and and then I moved on. But so that's what I did. Yeah, I'm an optimistic guy, but
you know what?
My thinking now. I still take a lot of jobs that I'm not crazy about, because a lot of jobs lead to other opportunities that are better. So
right.
You do it.
So how do you get a good, like, you actually, let's back up a little bit. You started, you had a job. You got an art job at a studio, doing educational work.
Right.
And then how did you end up moving, transitioning? Because a lot of people have a job that they, maybe they like, but they're not completely jazzed about, or maybe they want to be able to be home during the day and work on art and not have to go to a job. How do you make that transition?
For me, when I came out of college, I was working on my first, I had done my first picture book. And so when I was working with this educational software company, I was part-time illustrating a lot. And then after, I think it was about 10 years, my on-the-side freelance started to overpower all the other work. So I had enough work that I felt like I could transition and just be a full-time freelance.
Now, but didn't you get laid off?
No.
Oh, you didn't?
No, I quit.
Oh.
No, I wasn't laid off.
I thought that you were one of those guys that just got laid off and had a really good story, because then you had to, like, figure it out and scramble and make it. What you're saying is you had an easy life. And
no, I just got to a point where my illustration, my on-the-side illustration was, I had enough work that I felt like I could go full-time. And I wasn't really happy with what I was doing at the educational place. The creativity aspect of it was kind of lacking for me, and it wasn't really pushing me anymore, and so I wasn't enjoying it like I should, and so it was the timing. It was mostly just timing. I could move on.
Well, that's cool. So, how did you? Another question that I get asked a lot, and it's one of the reasons why I want to interview you, which you didn't even know you were getting interviewed.
No.
Is how did you go about getting those initial job? How were you getting the freelance? What were you doing to market, to advertise?
Well, okay, so when I was at this educational place, there was a student that came and got a job there. His name was Justin, and he also. He went to New York to do an internship with a rep in New York, and he was gone for, I don't know, 2 or 3 months. And when he came back, he worked with me for a long time, and then he took on a full-time position with this rep in New York. So I don't know what they said.
Or, nepotism.
Then the rep contacted me and asked if they could be my rep, and it seemed like the right thing to do. So I got a rep, and from that point on, they were able to find me work.
I realize that these are all the wrong answers.
It's not
because it sounds
the normal
easy
way to do things.
Like you got someone who made your career, and you just sat back and didn't have to do anything.
My whole career has been like, I've had really awesome opportunities fall in my lap. And so I feel really fortunate for all the things that I've had a lot of things just fall into place at the right time. And
did you also win the lottery? Did you win like the million mega ball or something like that?
It was like 500,000.
Okay, so, but now, here's the problem. Now that I'm trying to steer this interview, have you noticed that? Like, if I don't like the answers to the questions I'm getting, I'll just ask questions like an attorney.
So you're saying you don't like my answers?
Well, the thing is...
No, I understand.
It's harder now, I'd say, probably, to have a rep kind of just start getting you work, because even reps now, with the fact that the internet has globalized the marketplace, even a lot of reps are struggling a lot more than they used to. Would you agree with that?
No, I agree.
Okay.
Yeah, I agree.
Definitely. Let the record show that Guy Francis agrees with that one. Okay, so.
I think that the reps are having a harder time finding jobs for the artists that they represent. But again, I've been fortunate to have some projects that have carried me through the really slow times.
Uh-huh.
you know, I'm working on a series, or for some reason the children's book market didn't get hit as hard as some of the other illustration markets.
Mm-hmm.
And so I've been fortunate to have, like, some good work coming in during the slowest times.
Now, here's the thing. You call it fortunate, but at the same time, you draw really well, right? I mean, you can just go ahead and toot that horn, but I mean, like, you can't just be, I mean, you draw really well. People look at your work, go to Guy, what is it, GuyFrancis.com?
Yeah.
And, you know, I mean, now, the other thing is, you didn't always draw that well, right?
Well, I mean, yeah, it's like anything, you have to work at it. But I've drawn my whole life.
You were blessed and you drew well from the day one, like, from the...
When I was 3, I picked up a pencil and just never put it down.
Do you think that the level of your drawing skill has to do with... is there a direct correlation between the amount of jobs you're going to get offered?
I think so. Yeah. I mean, if you're drawing every day and you improve your skills, you're bound to get other people. I mean, you're going to get better the more you draw.
Right.
Just, you know, there's no doubt about that. And if you're honing your skills all the time and you're drawing stuff that you love, then there's going to be people out there that you know, will recognize that, hopefully, and will hire you to do stuff that you like to do. So, yeah.
So if you were starting today, what do you think what advice would you give for marketing, for actually finding the work? Have you thought about that?
For new illustrators?
Yeah, for someone new that's trying to quit their crappy job.
I recently had to speak at a SCBWI conference, and I called a bunch of art directors and agents and stuff and interviewed them and asked them what do they look for from a new artist coming out. And the biggest thing that they wanted to see is they want to be able to have access to your art quickly. It used to be that, you know, when we started, you and I, you had to really send out your portfolio or you drop it off at a publisher and then come back a few days and pick it up, things like that. But they still say that the postcard is one of the best things that they get. And so you send out a promotional postcard that has a website. You have to have a website that they can look at if they like your postcard, they want to see if you can draw other stuff, and they want to see it immediately. They don't want to have to click through a million things. They want to just know right away if you can do what they want you to do. So
yeah,
that's the biggest thing. I'd say, you know, you can send out promotional postcards, but the website is essential. The trick is you've got to get your artwork in front of the people that hire artists. And if you can't do that, you're never going to get work. You got to get out there somehow. Whether it's a rep, for some people like myself, a rep is extremely valuable. For someone like Will, who's just got the, you know, he's worshipped by people all over the world. You know, some people can do it without a rep, and some people, it doesn't fit my personality to self-promote. But it works really well with you. So
I actually have a rep now.
Do you really?
Yeah. Yeah, Mohammed Donaway, Illozoo.
Nice.
Illozoo. But thank you. And I think we'll end right now because you give us some gold there. And then we'll look at the show up here.
All right. I'm not terribly hungry though, so I'll just get like a...
Okay. Well, let's not order here. Let's go in. Good. Hey, I'm just wondering, can I get a Happy Meal for breakfast?
No.
Can I get a Happy Meal, like, now?
No.
Okay.
At 10:30.
Ah. Do you know if you have... My friend out here, he illustrated the Clark the Shark book, and that you're giving away in that Happy Meal, and we're wondering if we could get one.
No, we are actually not doing the Happy Meals right now.
Okay.
There are some McDonald's who do them. There are other McDonald's who don't.
Okay, thank you so much.
Make sure you guys have a lovely day.
All right.
Sorry about that.
So, I guess the answer is nay. You may not have your book at McDonald's. We're too early.
Did you hear what he said?
We're not doing that.
I don't think he got what you were asking.
No, he doesn't understand. In fact, it's funny because, you know, at different times I've asked, my wife has done something where she said, hey, can we get this book? My husband illustrated it. And they look at you like, they don't know what that means.
I know.
Like, no one illustrates books, you know? So.
He's still stuck on, no, we don't serve Happy Meals in
right,
the morning.
Right.
Well, that's not what we're asking. We're asking if you have a book. Question.
Anyway. We will find your book. You've got one at home, right?
Yeah, I do.
So one way or another, we're going to see this book. Okay. Okay, so here's his book right here. There's Clark the Shark. Here's Guy Francis right here. Here's the McDonald's where they won't give us a Happy Meal, but we're still going to try. I'll tell you something. This guy's famous here.
No,
He illustrated that book, Clark the Shark, and we're wondering if you have one. That goes in the Happy Meal. The one with the shark. Do you have one back there?
No.
Can we see one? We'll see.
Don't film me.
So what are you guys videotaping about?
He illustrated the book that's in the Happy Meal.
Really?
That's the artist right there, yeah. Nice. The shark one.
Oh. So. Yeah. Why didn't you do that if you give a mouse a cookie in the book?
Yeah, exactly.
Either there's if you give a mouse something, but it should be if you give a mouse a cookie.
That's right. Laura Numeroff. Like, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. See? They know. They know good literature in the columns. That's right. You think they're going to come up with it?
I don't know.
She's looking. Oh, she doesn't have it. Did you find it? You didn't find it? Oh, darn. Okay, well, we tried. Blink. So, I think that's the book right there, that blue one right next to the monitor. Yeah, right there. That's it. That's it. No, the shark, the other one. The other one. The shark. Yeah. There it is right there. See, it says Guy Francis. That's Guy Francis right there. Yeah. Yay. You didn't want us to have to go through all this, did you?
No.
All right, now it's time to get some breakfast. Oh, I'm getting one. Awesome. Oh my gosh. Woo! I missed the promotion because it was Valentine's Day only. Okay, so here we are at the Bountiful Davis Art Center, and the reason I'm doing voiceover is because I must have hit record or didn't hit record or something, but I ended up with a lot of nothing and just a little bit of footage inside. So I thought I'd just tell you about what we did, since I can't really tell you on the video a whole lot. There's a guy pretending to open the door for me. Chivalry is not dead. Okay, so the other thing was, for some reason the camera was blurry, and then it cleared up, so I don't know if it like had fog on it or something, but anyway, my criteria for judging is cred. Concept, rendering, execution, and design. Those were my criteria for looking at these pieces of art. And we basically looked at and picked out our favorites. We went independently, picked out our favorites, and then we kind of eliminated from the bottom. And then we just kind of made cases and arguments for the stuff in the middle. There's some of my pieces that I got to put in there. And then we stopped at our friend Mel Milton's house on the way home.
Come on in.
What do you think about being an illustrator?
Into the garbage you go.
All right, so what do we got here? We got one of the Mel's Dukes here. Open that up. So he's got all kinds of cool pictures in here. And we got an exclusive copy, right? So we're bragging right now.
Yeah, definitely bragging.
Because I got one too.
Look at that. A book full of the master.
Look at that. Yeah, oh, we better turn this off. He doesn't want it.
He's coming back.
He's coming back. We don't.
So there you have it. That was about it. And, you know, I hope to be able to do more videos where I take the camera out, because I think just talking in front of my webcam is kind of boring. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this one, and I'll catch you on my next one.